THQ.
Too scary for me.
Come on, this is like the best ride they've got. It's gonna be great.
Okay, well it better not be too fast.
You'll be fine. Besides, I'm here to protect you.
Oh, whatever.
Here we go! Wait, it's gonna get better.
Oh, come on. I can walk faster than this. What's the point of a ride like this anyway? Why go 5 miles an hour when you should be going 90?
Lesson one, basic driving. Hey, I'm Andy Pierce, and this is the basic training session for Splashdown Rides Gone Wild. I'll be running you through each lesson. Watch me first, and then you get to try it yourself. Cool? We'll start with the simple stuff, driving your Sea-Doo. The X button is the throttle. To accelerate, just press and hold the X button, and see you later. The Sea-Doo watercraft has no brakes, so just release the X button and the water's resistance will bring you to a stop. Pretty easy. Okay, now you try it. Accelerate towards the gate at the far end and stop once you've passed it. That's some good stuff right there. Lesson 2, turning. Moving the left analog stick or directional buttons left or right shifts your rider's position and turns the handlebars. This is what allows you to steer your Sea-Doo. You can also move the left analog stick or directional buttons up or down to shift your rider's position forward and backward on the seat. This causes your Sea-Doo to dip in or out of the water. We'll cover that some more later on. Okay, up ahead are two buoys. You need to pass these buoys on the side with the flags. Try not to hit the blue training guidelines on the sides of the path. Hold the X button to give your Sea-Doo some gas, and then use the left analog stick or directional buttons to steer around these buoys. Make sure you pass them on the correct side, okay? That's the side with the flag. Oh, and you won't turn as well without accelerating, so keep holding the X button. Stop when you've passed these two buoys. That's some good stuff right there. Okay, there are three more buoys set up at the corner just ahead. Just steer around them and come to a stop like so. Okay, you're up. Good job. All right, we'll just tighten things up a bit. The three buoys up ahead are spaced a little closer together than the other ones. You'll need to turn just a little harder as you go around them. And that's it. Okay, now you try it. Steer around the three buoys up ahead. And remember, don't hit the blue guidelines, okay? Stop once you've passed the finish gate. Great! You'll be handling tough slaloms in no time. Lesson 3. Pitch and landing. You'll be getting a lot of air in this game. Big air. Taking off, now that's the easy part. Landing's a bit trickier though. Land at the wrong angle and you'll lose a lot of speed, or worse, wipe out. Not good. Luckily, you can adjust your Sea-Doo's pitch while you're airborne. Just move the left analog stick or directional buttons up or down while airborne to adjust your pitch. Try to match your Sea-Doo's angle to the slope of the ramp or terrain below you for a smooth landing. Okay, now it's your turn. Accelerate towards a ramp, take off, and then adjust your pitch before landing on the blue slide. Go for it! Yeah, smooth like a baby's egg. Yeah, well, you know. Lesson 4, Performance Meter 1, buoys. The performance meter is the bar to the right of your speedometer. The one shaped like a crescent or a hot dog. Anyway, it shows the performance level of your Sea-Doo, from base performance to peak performance, improving your speed and acceleration rate. During gameplay, you'll need to build up the performance meter to get the most out of your vehicle. You do this by pulling off stunts. However, passing buoys also affects the performance meter. Many of the courses in the game feature buoys. As we learned in Lesson 2, you have to pass the buoy on the side with the flag. If you don't, and you skip the buoy, you'll lose points from the performance meter. You don't want to do that, especially if the meter's already empty. If you skip a buoy with an empty meter, you'll stall for a moment. Not good during a race. See what happened? Try not to do that. Okay, your turn. Run through these buoys on the correct side. Away with you! Okay, good, but I'm gonna stop you for a second. Okay, now I want you to purposely skip these last two buoys, so you see what it's like when the engine stalls. Go ahead and pass these buoys on the left side. Gold star! Lesson 5, Performance Meter 2, stunts. Okay, so you can actively upgrade the top speed and acceleration of your Sea-Doo by adding points to the performance meter. You do this by pulling off stunts. When you get air, start a stunt. pressing and holding one of the three stunt buttons, the L1, R1, or R2 button. Then push up, down, left, or right with the left analog stick or directional buttons. You've got to release the stunt before you hit the water again, though, or else you'll get a shaky landing. Okay, you try it. Race around the course, catching air off the ramps and pulling off stunts. Hold one of the stunt buttons, the L1, R1, or R2 button, and then press up, down, left, or right with the left analog stick or directional buttons. Try to fill up the first block of the performance meter by doing this. Hey, that was really good! The stunts you just tried are called Tier 1. There are 12 of them in the game, but that's just the beginning. There are actually more than 60 different stunts you can do. We'll get into that in advanced training, though. One more thing. The performance meter drops down over time, so keep it filled up by doing a stunt whenever possible. Lesson 6, submarine. Sometimes you'll come up on an obstacle that you can dive beneath. That's called submarining. Pushing forward on the left analog stick or up on the directional buttons will shift your rider's weight forward, forcing your Sea-Doo's nose into the water. Once you're fully submerged, release the left analog stick or directional buttons and you'll come back up. Try it! Accelerate towards the wall and then submarine to dive underneath it. Stop when you come back up. Okay, that's one down. Alright, that's one submarine, but can you handle two in a row? It's not a special move or anything, it's just a matter of timing. Approach the first wall, submarine beneath it, and then when you come up, be ready to go under again right away. Okay, have at it. You are now the submaster, or subhuman, Lesson 7, bunny hop. You don't always have to swerve around obstacles in your way. If they're low enough, you can jump over them. That's where the bunny hop comes in. If you've already got the submarine down, you'll be able to do this too. Instead of fully submerging your Sea-Doo when you dive, just dip the nose and then shift your weight back quickly. And that's the bunny hop. Try it. Head up towards the wall ahead. Just before you hit it, gently push forward, then quickly snap back on the left analog stick or directional buttons to make the hop. Hey, that was really good. Okay, ready to try for two? It's all about rhythm and timing. When you land from the first hop, be ready to do it again. Might take some practice, but that's about it. Go for it. That's right, you all about the rhythm. Anyway, nice work out there. You made it all the way through the basic training session. Here's something for your troubles, and I'll see you in the advanced session. Lesson 8, hydroplaning. Hey, I'm Andy Pierce, and this is the advanced training session for Splashdown Rides Gone Wild. If you haven't taken the basic training session yet, you probably want to start there. Otherwise, let's get to it. This lesson covers hydroplaning, which is used in the advanced simulation control mode. You can switch between arcade and simulation control on the select racer page. Anyway, when you hit top speed on a straightaway, you can hydroplane to go even faster. Pull back on the left analog stick or directional buttons and you'll shift your rider's weight back. This lifts the Sea-Doo's nose out of the water. Less of the hull surface on the water means less drag, so you'll pick up even more speed. Try it on this straightaway. Get up near top speed first, and then pull back. Ready? Go! Pretty good trick, right? Just don't try it around turns. Not good.
It burns!
Lesson 9, Tier 2 stunts. In Lesson 5, we covered the first 12 stunts in the game. Those are the Tier 1 stunts. Now we'll move up to the Tier 2s. The stunt system in this game allows you to link stunts together to build chains. You start a chain by pulling off one of the 12 Tier 1 stunts. You can branch to 3 different Tier 2 stunts. That's a total of 36 Tier 2 stunts. For instance, we'll start with the knack-knack. That's a Tier 1 stunt. You perform it by holding down the L1 button, then pressing left on the left analog stick or directional buttons, like so. Okay, now I'll add in one of the Tier 2 stunts that branch from the knack-knack. How about the handlebar handstand? To do that, I start the chain by holding the L1 button, then press left to do the knack-knack, then press up, and then up again on the left analog stick or the directional buttons, like this. So basically, to kick off a chain, you start by holding one of the 3 stunt buttons and then start entering inputs with the left analog stick or the directional buttons. Watch me do the knack-knack to handlebar handstand chain again. Hold the L1 button, then push left, then up. Sweet! Okay, now you try the chain I just performed. And don't forget to release the stunt button before you hit the water, or you'll wobble when you land. Go! Great job! Notice that the performance meter has filled up even more. You're in the second block now. That's because the 3 stunt tiers directly correspond to the 3 blocks in the performance meter. To fill up the first block, perform Tier 1 stunts. To fill up the second block, perform Tier 2 stunts, and so on. Here we'll try another Tier 2 stunt off of the knack-knack, the lightning rod. To do this one, hold the L1 button, then press left to do the knack-knack, and then press down, then up on the left analog stick or the directional buttons, like this. L1 button, left, down, up, ta-da! Ready to try it? Here are the controls. Have at it! Yeah, definitely a crowd pleaser. Okay, here's the last Tier 2 stunt combo, starting with the knack-knack. A knack-knack to a body variable. Now this one's a bit trickier. Start by holding the L1 button, then press left to do the knack-knack. Then press right, then right again with the left analog stick or directional buttons, like this. Here, watch the diagram. L1 button, left, right, got it! Okay, now you try it. Go around the course and try to perform the knack-knack to a body variable chain. The controls are on the screen for reference. Okay, good work out there. Okay, nice work out there. Now you just learned 3 of the Tier 2 stunts. 3 out of the 36, that is. If you want to learn the rest of them, you should check out the stunt library on the training page. Lesson 10, Tier 3 stunts. Performing a Tier 3 stunt is the fastest way to max out the performance meter. We're talking real power here, real speed. And if you've already learned how to do a Tier 2 stunt, then you've got most of this process down. In order to do a Tier 3 stunt, you must first perform a Tier 1 stunt, followed by a Tier 2 stunt. Each Tier 2 stunt links to 2 Tier 3 stunts. We worked with the knack-knack chain in the last lesson, so we'll continue with that here. Let's work off the first chain, the knack-knack, to a handlebar handstand. From the handlebar handstand, you can perform a whirly bird or a metronome. Here's how to do the metronome. Start by holding the L1 button, and then, using the left analog stick or the directional buttons, press left to do the knack-knack, then press up to do the handlebar handstand, and then press left, then right. Yeah, I know it sounds like a mouthful, but you can do it really quickly. Here, watch! Keep an eye on the diagram as I do this. The L1 button, left, up, and then left, then right. Done! I'm not gonna lie to you, Tier 3 stunts take practice. Once you get them down though, you'll be using them all the time to get the best performance out of your Sea-Doo. They also rack up the biggest points in the freestyle mode. Ready to try it? Remember, hold the L1 button, then using the left analog stick or the directional buttons, press left, up, up, left, right. The diagram's on the screen for your reference. Right on! You're gonna master this in no time! Okay, ready to try the Whirly Bird? If you got the metronome down, it's a piece of cake. All you're gonna do is press left twice at the end. Everything else is the same. So hold the L1 button, then press left, up, up, then left, and left again. Watch me. The ladies love that one. So go on, give it a shot. The controls are up there for you if you need them. Rock on! That's it for stunt chains. Not so bad, right? Now you're all set to learn the rest of the Tier 3 stunts. Go check them out in the stunt library. Lesson 11, barrel roll. Lessons 5, 9, and 10 cover Tier 1, 2, and 3 stunts. There are over 60 of those in the game. There are also 3 more stunts to cover though, vehicle-based stunts. These are the stunts that you can pull off by using your Sea-Doo. The first one is the barrel roll. Here's how you do it. Head towards a ramp. When you hit the ramp, hold the L2 button, and then, using the left analog stick or directional buttons, press left, then right. You've got to start the stunt while your Sea-Doo is on the ramp. If you do it correctly, you'll perform the roll when you catch air. Watch. Pretty cool, right? You can also do a barrel roll in the opposite direction as well. Just head up towards the ramp, hold the L2 button, then press right, then left. Okay, you ready to try a barrel roll? Doesn't matter which one you do, right or left. The controls are up on the screen. Great job! One more thing. All of the vehicle-based stunts are used to add points to the performance meter, no matter what block is currently filled. Lesson 12, invert. Here's the second of the 3 vehicle-based stunts, the invert. Other people call it a flip. We'll call it an invert. Same thing. If you got the barrel roll down, you've basically got this too. Head towards a ramp, hold the L2 button, and then, using the left analog stick or directional buttons, press up then down, or down then up. You can do a forward flip or a backflip, depending. I'll do a backflip. Watch the controls on the screen. Kids, don't try that at home. You can try it here though. Ready? Do a front flip or a back flip off of one of the ramps. Okay, way to go. Remember, you can do any of the vehicle stunts off of any ramp at any time and add points to the performance meter. Oh yeah, there's another way to do an invert, but you can figure that out for yourself. I'll give you a hint. It starts with a submarine. Lesson 13, flat spin. Here's the final vehicle-based stunt, the flat spin. The setup for this one is the same as the other 2 vehicle-based stunts. Head up towards the ramp, hold the L2 button, and then, using the left analog stick or directional buttons, press up then right, or up then left. I'll do a flat spin to the right. Ready to try it? Doesn't matter which direction you do it in, right or left. The controls are up on the screen. Hey, that was really good. Lesson 14, advanced turning. Okay, if you've made it this far, you've pretty much learned all the skills you'll need to master Splashdown, Rides Gone Wild. One last chunk of instructive goodness for you though, the art of the really tight turn. If you're playing with the simulation control mode, you'll definitely want to master this technique. In lesson 2, we covered turning. This slalom up ahead is pretty easy, and so I don't have to do anything more than turn left or right. Watch! Nothing too hard. That buoy up ahead, though, that's a hairpin turn. I'm gonna need to whip around that pretty quickly. The best way to do that is to duck the nose of the Sea-Doo a bit as I make the turn. Like this. You see? All you have to do is press up a bit with the left analog stick or directional buttons as you're making a left or right turn. Here, I'll do this next one up ahead. Just push the left analog stick or directional buttons to the upper left or upper right when you're making a tight turn. That's it. It even works for tight slaloms like the one up ahead. Piece of cake. Okay, your turn now. Pass through this easy slalom and then try to make that hairpin turn up ahead. Try not to hit the blue guidelines, okay? Stop when you've passed the buoy at the hairpin. Okay, good job. Now try the next hairpin. Don't hit the guideline. Okay, final run. Make it through the tight slalom up ahead without hitting the guidelines. You're all set. That brings us to the end of advanced training. Congratulations. Check out the big brain on you. There's nothing like the feel of real power between your legs. She may not look like much, but she's got it where it counts, kid. Okay, let's make like a baby and head out! Oh, hey, dude, I got you something. Oh, hey, dude, I got you something. Okay, let's go kick some booty!
Come back! Come back! Hello? our past, and so shall Amun-Ra!
You're gonna get totaled, Amun-Ra!
We'll be right back.
Thank you, sir. The check is in the mail. Come on, get him, we'll stick him. Ice, stop!
Thank you. you're all over the shop.
How can you say that after all we've been through?
Such insolence!
off the top, guys. I am a golden god. Yeah, okay, nice seeing you.
Thank you.
buzzard!
Thank you. Now that's the business!
Kung Fu Grip!
Scratchy, get me out of it! Takes a long spoon to sup with a fiver! My nipples are like bullets! Gladly, my cross-eyed bear!
because that was saucy!
This one, fringing boat! Get out, Choco!
That's right, just keep going!
Yes, keep going! And leave me alone!
Gotta be sus to pull this off!
Make way for the Greater Monroe!
Think you'd better not haul instead!
Thank you.
gather berries off just any bush.
Thank you. sweaty buckles!
Well, that's right, Bonzer!
Thank you.
notice it's crap! like a burst tomato, Ramen Ra! They draw a myth, this inside! Fair dose trick, that one! Me? Big girl's blouse.
Well, don't that beat all!
ticky, ticky, and a razzmatazz!
You can bugger off now! Away I go, never to return! Do what now? Pure! Thank you. Panzer!
Okay, bye-bye.
Out of the way, Reg!
So you shall see the power of Amara!
Bit of a ding-dong, Chablam! Try to keep up, wee one!
Skittles now!